So is L4-L5 disc bulge curable? Can an L4-L5 disc bulge be repaired? Can it get back to normal? Can it be resolved, an L4-L5 disc bulge? In fact, can any disc bulge be fixed or resolved? That's one of the most common questions I get asked on my comment sections below my videos right here on my channel. So I want to answer this question for you today. Helping you relieve pain, conquer stress, and supercharge your health the chiropractic way.
And if you're new to my channel, be sure to click on that subscribe button and the notification bell so you get notifications on all my new videos that come out weekly, so you know how to relieve pain, conquer stress, supercharge your health naturally, safely, and effectively.
Hi, my name is Dr. Walter Salubro from Back to Health Chiropractic Center in Vaughan, Ontario. And it's one of the most commonly asked questions I get is about disc bulges and what kind of options can be done to help prevent surgery and how could the problem that causes disc bulge be corrected. So I want to address that today. But most people do ask me if it's curable or not. And I understand why they're asking that, because many people that have been found to have a disc bulge and associated symptoms such as low back pain or muscle stiffness or restricted mobility or shooting pain down the legs like sciatica type pain or radiating pain down the legs, numbing and tingling discomfort or irritation down the legs. That's a concern, and it's very disabling to have these type of low back condition, disc condition, and also these type of symptoms. And the truth is, many people that I have talked to or have heard in my comment sections below, in my YouTube channels, my YouTube videos, have actually told me that they want to prevent surgery. So they want some hope to see if this disc bulge is actually fixable. Now, let me address that and kind of clear some misconceptions or some confusion here. The one thing to get, I think what people are asking me is, can someone that has a disc bulge get back to a normal functionality, get back to living the normal life free of pain? And the truth is that if you have a disc bulge or even a herniation, it's very possible to provide or to receive certain types of treatment and care that will help you get back to a normal level of function in your life. And I'll talk about that in a moment. So yes, it is. And it's very also possible that surgery can also be prevented. Now, I don't use words like cure. I don't know if an L4 or L5 disc bulge can actually be cured. But I do know that the associated symptoms that come with disc bulges can be cleared up. And I do know that people can actually return back to normal function. How? Because I've seen it day in and day out, week in and week out in my office, in my chiropractic office. And I think what's important to know is that it's not so much about curing the disc bulge, but it's more about correcting the structural problem that led to the derangement in the disc or the disruption of the disc or even the disc bulge. So let me explain. So here's a spinal model. Right? So low back spinal model. So there's 5 vertebrae. In between each bone are discs. That would be an example of a disc bulge right there. And this is a lateral disc bulge, but some go posterior lateral, which means back into the side, and some go centrally straight back. So once the disc is disrupted and it's bulged, that's essentially irreversible permanent damage to that disc. When the disc loses height or has become dried up, that's irreversible damage to the disc. So you're not gonna really change much of that structural disruption of the disc. However, what I wanna know is what caused it, what led to that disruption, to that bulge. If someone's spine was tilting like that, then that could lead over years and decades, can lead to a disruption in the fibers of the disc that causes the inside nucleus to actually bulge out. So my question is what caused this alignment problem? Or what's going on to cause a disruption of the disc, and is it an alignment problem? What if the alignment problem is going forward like that? That will disrupt the disc forward and also possibly bulge it backwards. What if it's going backwards like that? That again can disrupt the disc and go backwards. So the appropriate question is what can be actually done to correct the structural abnormality to reduce the pressure on the irritation of the disc and thereby alleviate the inflammation and inflammatory response that's associated with the disc bulge, and therefore alleviate all of the associated symptoms that come with that. And one of the best things that I've seen and helped a lot of people with is corrective chiropractic care and chiropractic care in general. And that is involved with adjusting and correcting the actual spinal misalignments, also called subluxations. And in doing so, when you realign the spine into a better position, a more optimal, ideal position, what it does biomechanically and structurally, it actually reduces the abnormal stress on the disc that led to the disruption and bulge in the first place. And in doing so, when the abnormal stress is eliminated, now the disc actually has time to breathe, essentially, to actually exist free of irritation. Therefore, there's no need for the body to produce an inflammatory response there. And therefore, when there's no inflammation, there's no swelling, and all the cardinal signs that come with inflammation, the blood flow and the irritation that goes there that triggers pain response. So all that begins to get reduced and eliminated. And that's what happened with many of my patients that have disc bulges, is we correct the structural underlying problem, misalignment of the spine, in doing so, indirectly relieve the pressure, and also sometimes even directly, on the disrupted disc, and now give it a chance to heal. So the question lies then, is the disc bulge still there if someone doesn't feel it? And it's most likely still there. And I've seen that in post MRI reports. But I have many patients that are doing better with their disc bulge condition. They have reduced back pain by 90%, have reduced or eliminated the actual progression to surgery, so eliminated surgery, have reduced their intake of medication, are walking normally, are standing normally, are bending and working and playing and doing all the things in their day-to-day activities that they find as normal, and they're living the life that they want without the drugs or reduced drugs, without the surgery, and getting their back in shape with specific chiropractic adjustments. And of course, we also provide supportive recommendations such as core exercise, training, mobilization, balance work, a bunch of other things to add to the stability of the spine once the spine's been corrected. So I know it's kind of a long answer, but I hope that answers your question. If a disc bulge can be cured, and the key is to remember that it's not so much about curing or fixing the disc bulge, but to correct the structural abnormality or the structural misalignment, also called subluxations, of the spine that led to the disruption of the disc. And I've seen that happen over and over again in our office with corrective chiropractic care. Hope you found that explanation useful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and get more videos here on my channel. Hit that notification bell so you get immediate notification on updates and videos on my channel so you don't miss out on any fresh content. Thank you for being a subscriber or a watcher on my YouTube channel, and I'll see you again in the next video. To learn more about how corrective chiropractic care at Back to Health Chiropractic Center can help you with your chronic pain problem, visit www.ibthcc.com. Back to Health Chiropractic Center is located at 20 Cranston Park Avenue, No. 6, Vaughan, Ontario, L6A2W2.